Hey, what's going on, y'all? Thank you so much for tuning in. My name is Ayoka, getting ready to bring you your Virgo energy update, okay? So make sure you flip these roles, take only what you need and leave the rest, and please use the spirit of discernment as you're viewing this video, all right? I don't know if you're masculine or feminine. I'm just going to speak this story how I see it. Don't force it, y'all. Hold on. Try to make sure that ain't too loud, okay? And if you're triggered by anything, I do encourage you to face your mirror. My job is to help you to evolve here on your journey so that you can begin to manifest the best goddamn life you deserve and desire. All right, so make sure y'all hit the like button, thanks button, subscribe button if you're feeling my vibe. I definitely appreciate all your support, okay? So what I got is the angel of love coming out in the reverse position, the sun card coming out in the reverse position. This looks like a cloudy ass day, okay? But look, a lot of cards may have dropped out. Let me check and see what's going on. Oh, okay. All right, so angel of love in the reverse. So somebody that you got this tender connection with, right? It could be a love connection or some sort of friendship. You guys have some type of disconnect, okay? Yeah, I feel like if you are the feminine of my collective, you have been doing a lot of self-love work as well, and maybe possibly even withdrawing your energy from this connection, and this is what is creating the rift on top of, you know, the role that they may be playing to. Now, with the sun card is in a reverse position, I definitely feel like you could be blocked in your happiness in some kind of way, like something is definitely making you not feel so optimistic. So, you're being asked to rest, okay? So I don't know if this is something that's past energy for you guys or if it's actually happening in real time right now, okay? But take some time to get grounded, all right? Rest and rejuvenate in the reverse, because you want this drama to end. And spirit got a whole message for you, okay? You guys, some downloads that is coming to you, and honey, you are missing it, okay? Just letting you know. All right, all tied up card is in a reverse position, right? So that this drama can come to an end. You do not want this to stop you from moving forward, okay? Or make you feel oppressed in any kind of way, because you got to keep your joy during this time, honey. Why? Because having your vibes high is what helps you to manifest your desired outcome, okay? The yin and yang card comes in a reverse next to the fourth chakra in a reverse position. Now, what I feel like here is this more about, you know, your guides telling you, look, it's time for you to become a little bit more logical here with your approach, okay? The emotions is too much. Balance these energies is what I'm hearing, all right? Balance your intuition, your emotions, be clear in your thinking with your logic. So that's like that feminine masculine energy, right? Because now it's going to be time for you to put more of that into trying to create whatever this new beginning is for yourself. I do definitely feel like a lot of us are in a whole new cycle right now, okay? And having this old pain and this old grief, okay, this old sense of abandonment, whatever these feelings are that you are feeling, is stopping you from attracting the love that's actually available to you, is what I'm hearing, y'all. I mean, I'm sorry if that sounds like I'm coming off a little harsh, but that's not my intentions, but it's how it's coming to me. It's like I keep hearing my spirit team like, look, you got problems and they got problems. It's both of y'all. Stop pointing the blame. There is a block in the flow of someone's heart center, okay? And that grief that's lingering is what's stopping you or this person from caring, okay, and attracting the love. But I feel like that's falling for the feminine, all right, of my collective. That grief that's lingering is stopping you from caring, and it's making you not feel so optimistic any longer, and making you actually just kind of like, it's like giving in or folding on what you actually believe in, even if it's just not the fact about being with a particular person. It could be you believing in love, period. Okay, and of course you guys already know how this flow. If your person is very emotionally, physically, mentally abusive, okay, and narcissistic and some other bull, and it's like a very harmful situation. I'm not laughing to laugh at y'all, but I mean, like, you get it. Like, I'm even thinking about some times when I was with my karmic person and like how detrimental that relationship can be on your soul. If it's like that, I'm not talking to you, sweetheart. Okay. I'm not talking to you. You got to let that situation go, okay? And start to work on your own self-love and heal, all right? The universe is definitely talking to us all because it's time for us all collectively to heal, all right? So let's talk about this All Tied Up card. Yep, between the lovers. So that's what I'm saying. I feel like it's a twin flame message. Let me tell you, it's because what's happening, and I'm going to pull and I'm going to see what's up. What's happening across the board for twin flames right now, it's like we're nearing, how do I want to put it? What came to my mind just now was union. And it feels like it's union of self because you know the twin flame journey is really about your soul's evolution and your life purpose, basically, right? And what we're working on and trying to obtain is our own wholeness, right? All right, so that union is going to be with self, not union as far as with your lover, your twin flame, but more of but look, don't forget, okay? Even though, right, you come into this completion, okay, of your cycles, you are now operating in this state of wholeness. You are mastering that self-love. You are letting go of the stuff that no longer serves you. You're doing all of these wonderful things for yourself. It's still helping the connection. So even though it's like that union of self, I say, you still are creating union with your person because you now are both operating in duality. You're balancing your energies perfectly, okay? You're vibing on the same frequency at this point, okay? That still is what creates that union, all right? So try not to, what I keep hearing is like, look at the bigger picture, okay? Archangel Michael is ruling over this connection. It's divinely ordered. Everything that you have been experiencing in this connection is divinely ordered. It's happening so that you guys can let go of these this drama, okay? These behaviors, these patterns, this heartbreak, the grief, the pain, the abandonment issues, the rejection, all of that stuff. That's why you guys are going through this, because you are in spiritual training. And spirit wants to know, hey, you gonna walk away from them cups that no longer serve you or nah, okay? Because it's time for you to walk towards your higher purpose in life, and this is hindering you. And it's hindering the connection that you're supposed to have with your person, because you are supposed to be working together as a team. And it doesn't necessarily mean, again, relationship. It could be friendships, working on building the friendship, working on building the connection, bringing the harmony and the balance between each other so that it can eventually evolve to something deeper, okay? I know the eagerness is usually what keeps us from being able to, you know, to stay balanced, right? King of Cups comes out and the King of Swords reverse. This person, this masculine energy, they love you. They love you. And what I'm hearing is that they are definitely willing, okay, to make whatever adjustments that they need. I feel like this person know that they lack the structure. King of Swords, reverse energy. We got water sign and air sign energy on the board. Gemini standing out with the lovers. But I do feel like this masculine energy knows that they lack the structure and they have not been using their head. I feel like they know that they have caused and created a lot of heartbreak. And this is why this person is willing to make the adjustments to get some things right here is what I'm seeing. They're taking on a different approach is what I just heard with that yin and yang card. They're now getting ready to put forward a more active approach. So if you are the feminine of my collective, you detaching in some kind of way, whatever tower moment that you may have had, okay? If you haven't had one yet, it may be one coming. It's like a fiery one. On top of that, it can be, really explosive. So be mindful of your energy and make sure you are communicating clearly, okay? Three of Swords in a reverse position here. You guys are going to be able to heal from this situation and move forward. Yep. And that's what everything is about. I feel like here, you may have it been repressing the hurt, repressing your hurt, and it's creating the resentment towards this person. And it's building up, it's just building up. You, as you're looking at this person, it's like, damn it, it don't look like they changing. It don't look like they moving forward. It don't look like they are doing nothing. Okay, I got the Knight of Pentacles reversed, the Six of Swords reversed, the Knight of Wands reversed, and it's triggering. So now you're trying to make certain decisions for yourself here that is going to actually serve you, and you don't feel left out in the cold. Okay. I don't know if you guys checked out my video last night that I posted, but definitely check that out. It says, Virgo, this person is trustworthy. All right. They care about you and will act accordingly. Coming out King of Cups energy off the back. Okay. So let me see what Archangel Michael got for y'all tonight. Whoop, forgiveness. Forgive yourself. You have done nothing wrong. Your home is protected, and spend more time outdoors. We get that every day, don't we? It's like, it don't matter what deck I pull from. They be like, you need to get outside. Get grounded. You blocked your intuition. You tripping. Okay, ground yourself, boo, so you can hear what's going on here. Your angelic team is working things out, honey, for your highest good. Okay, so hold on, y'all. All right, so I want to look at this. Forgive yourself. You have done nothing wrong. See what that says. Archangel Michael sees the guilt is interfering with the happiness you seek. You're blaming yourself for something that's in the past, but it's time to let it go, especially since self-blame is unproductive and unhealthy. In truth, you've done nothing wrong. You were doing the best you could at the time. Think and speak lovingly about yourself. Stop ruminating about the past. Send blessings to those you are angry with as a way of healing yourself in a situation. Know that you can't control other people's feelings or reactions. Okay, you may need to join a support group, all right? The book said it, y'all, okay? Don't come for me. But however, yes, get some help. Tell me about the forgive yourself. Ask your angels to help you and guide you in releasing any toxic anger or fear, okay? That resentment, even if it's self-blame, forgive yourself too as well. It's a masculine energy coming through that's doing that. The King of Cups reverse, okay? They're triggered, all right? They're highly triggered by this. And again, like I said, it's like they feel bad. They feel bad because they know that they have definitely hurt you. They hurt you in so many ways. And it could have been done differently. It's just that they were lacking the moral sense. It's not something here where I feel like it was abusive, okay? Type of hurt. It's just more of them making bad choices, okay? For the connection, for themselves, and everything. All right, so they're blaming themselves extremely here for everything that has taken place and how your connection is going, because I feel like if you are the feminine in my collective, you may be having a hard time moving past this. It's like a feeling of a lack of trust. It's like you still kind of holding on to some of the things that they may have done, and it's just like it's triggering for you, and it's hard for you to kind of move past it because you don't feel safe or stable. And you don't feel that way is because of everything that has transpired. And they know that you are still in this energy because of the simple fact that everything that they did, they realized the shit they did, okay? So they are triggered. And spirit wants them to really just go through this transition, forgive themselves, and keep moving forward. Because Justice Masculine has definitely made a lot of bad choices for themselves, created a lot of karma for themselves. Okay, so show me what I need to see. Yeah, the Emperor card comes out so that they can, yeah, that's what, how I'm seeing it, the way I said it. It's like the divine is wanting this masculine to just begin to take control of their life. And what I keep hearing, because even from yesterday, the card that came out is like, people make mistakes. And this is what this masculine was doing, making mistakes, but they were doing it out of their lower self, okay? Operating from that ego mind, which is what their own hurt, their own grief, their own heartbreak, and their own pain, okay? They were literally self-sabotaging themselves, which was self-sabotaging their connections, because they felt like, again, that they weren't worthy enough as well. Okay, I definitely feel like it's some mirroring energy. It's almost like you guys experience the same hurt, the same grief. Yeah, look at that. Queen of Pentacles comes out. So you and this person here are definitely mirroring each other's energy and working on becoming more balanced and stable when it comes to your money, when it comes to, you know, your family and everything. Okay, so I'm definitely feeling like that mirroring energy is happening, where you guys are trying to build yourselves to that point and learning certain lessons and trying to close out certain cycles. It's just that, right, Seven of Cups is in the reverse. It's like, this is a choice that you guys are making for yourselves individually. It's just the fact that it's hard for you guys to come together and open up to each other because of the devil energy, right? Because of the ego, the patterns, the habits, the feelings of... So this is what I just heard. Like, someone may have disregarded your feelings in your past. Okay. I mean, they totally disregarded your feelings. And this is what keeps you really guarded in this connection. You don't open up. You don't open up because you feel like this person is going to disregard how you feel. So it's hard for you to be vulnerable with this person and to express these emotions and to show that side of you, because you feel like you're going to be disregarded. So this is something here that you are still kind of carrying from your past into this connection now. And what I'm hearing again is like, this person is trustworthy. So this is the aspect of yourself that the divine is calling you to work on, okay? Page of Wands comes out in the reverse position. So not only if, you know, if it's not you still being with this particular person, but so you won't carry that over into the next relationship or even friendships as well. Okay, so it's one of these things here where you were connected to someone who was very unreliable. Okay, very hasty. Okay, they failed to commit. And I feel like this is a past person. Like, this is beyond the person that is... that's coming through here now, which I'm hearing for majority of you is a twin flame. Yeah, Six of Swords. It's time for you to move on beyond that situation. Move on from that pain. That's old pain. It's outdated. And what I heard is like, that person was a karmic. This is where these codependencies, I mean, of course, coming from childhood, but a lot of some of the stuff that you are holding on to and repressing is from that situation, okay? It's time for you to feel more in control of your life. And like I said, I feel like this is for both of you. This masculine and this masculine energy and feminine energy here with the Two of Pentacles in a reverse position. Again, it's like, this is what's bringing the imbalance between you two. So now it's time for y'all to be the yin and the yang, okay? Balance your energies. This is how you guys create the union, is what I'm hearing. And again, like I said, if this is a twin flame connection that I'm speaking of, the best way for the twins to come together is to be on the same frequency. They have to be an energetic match to each other, balanced. Duality, okay, in order to work well together. All right, We're called to be outside and outdoors because of the nature of the work that we do and the healing that we, you know, this is our spiritual journey. This is our healing journey. It takes a lot of energy. Okay, so you got to get outdoors. Like, I went outside today. I mean, this is one of my long days at work. So I know you guys see my eyes kind of like, I'm tired. So I'm like fighting to kind of keep my eyes open right now. But I'm going to finish up just a little bit. And then I'm going to go ahead and take it down and go to sleep. But this is my long day at work. So I usually come home and I can't stay up. I fall asleep. But nope, I stayed up a little bit. Then I got up. I went outside, made sure I took me a jog. And I did it at the park so I can be amongst the trees and stuff like that. And came in. Let me do a personal reading real quick. Boom. And do y'all's. Okay, so yeah. But ground yourself. Spend some more time outside because this is going to help relax you, motivate you, and help you with your intuition. Show me what I need to see. Thank you. Yep, look at that. Whips. Woo, this is what it's been like, right? Feel like you've been getting your ass whipped by the universe because it got the number 11 on this card. That's what it feel like, right? Because look, I did a Virgo reading a couple of days ago where it was like, this is going to be one of the hardest. Was it Virgo? Hardest lessons that you're going to have to learn. Hold up. Oh, yeah. This was for Virgo, a mature woman. And this is a twin flame situation. This is going to be a tough lesson, but spirit believes in you so much. Your divine masculine made a bad choice. Y'all see how? That's what I'm telling y'all. Y'all got to check out all these videos because it's like a continuation from, you understand, the day before. It's a whole daggone sitcom, okay? So look, it says repetition of the same thought or physical action develops into a habit which repeated frequently enough becomes an automatic reflex. Damn. And that's what it is. That's what I was getting ready. I was telling somebody I was talking to. It's my homegirl I talked to. And she's from Florida. She used to be my client. But we connected basically because of that twin flame community. And we help each other. And we talk about the stages of the journey together. And we collectively come together to see like, okay, this is what we're supposed to be doing in this phase to get past this. And I said that to myself. It's like... It's a habit and it's like automatic. It's an automatic reflex for me to behave a certain way. And it's like I don't even realize I'm doing it until today. It was made very clear. Like, oh shit. Oh, it's me. I'm the problem. I'm going to go back and I'm going to read it real quick because I'm telling you, it's like once you get that epiphany, it comes through. It's like, oh man, I have a problem with being vulnerable, you guys. And I'm going to share this with you because, you know, y'all my peoples and I want to help y'all to evolve. We on the same timeline, you know. So a lot of this stuff I'm going through, you go through just as much, right? That's why I'm here to teach y'all about it. But, I realize I'm really emotionally unavailable. We be like, why am I always keep attracting these emotionally unavailable people in my life? Because you are too. Okay, we begin to shut down emotionally towards people because we don't want to be hurt. We fear the hurt. We fear the rejection and everything. And so what I'll do is because I don't want to show my vulnerability because again, I have had a partner who has disregarded my feelings the whole way through, okay? And when it comes to me, you know, being transparent in that nature and being vulnerable, I'm not good at that. I struggle with that. So I'll do a lot of ghosting. I'll do a lot of hermit. And ghosting to me is just like I go in hermit mode. So I'll just be to myself. I won't really necessarily contact you. I won't express exactly how I'm feeling. It's in my head, but I'm trying to get the thoughts together and I'm trying to formulate the thoughts because I don't want to show my vulnerability. So I want to make sure it's coming across real structured and clear. You understand? So instead of me just being like, my feelings hurt because you did so and so. But when I used to do that, I used to have my ex used to, you know, really just be like, oh, what he used to say, that's because you don't got no self-esteem. You feel like that because you ain't confident. Like, just really would berate me and totally disregarding how I felt about it. And that's what it is, okay? It's just being able to express yourself, to be vulnerable and stop allowing these barriers to be, you know, that boundary between you and your person, the unhealthy boundary between you and your person, because I feel like this person would be willing to communicate. This person would be willing to try to find some type of solution because, again, like I said, this person, this masculine energy really cares about this feminine, okay? The divine feminine. I'm already going to call it how the shit is, right? And it's like we have to really try to find that compassion. All right. And even when I remember from doing a reading, it's like this is a time where we're going to be learning how to operate in unconditional love. That's what's next for us. This lesson is definitely going to be one for the books, y'all. Okay, that's all I'm going to say. One for the books. Okay. Let me see. Yeah, so that's what I'm going to be working on. I'm facing my mirror, y'all. 10:22 p.m. here in Baltimore. Spirit already telling me, face your mirror, girl. Because it's an automatic reflex for me to do it. It's like I notice it. It's like, that's why I fight myself. Because I notice that I'll do it each time. It's like, I'll be good. And then I'll be like, oh, shit, I feel triggered. And I feel that same thought, that same pattern begins to boil up inside of me, and I try to fight it so hard, and honey, that joint be like boom. I'll be like, and it end up being like the same thing over and over again. Like, and I'll even tell my twin, like, look, I don't want to talk about it because it's repetitive. I said it already before and it sound like a broken record and I don't want to talk about it no more. And it's not that I'm saying like what we're going through or me saying is like you're not hearing me. It's like it's me saying the same thing over and over again. And it's like this automatic reflex of mine to keep responding that same exact way. But it's my fear. Okay. I won't open up. I won't communicate. It's the fear. And it's my intentions to communicate. It's just that I'm the one that has to make sure what I'm going to say is going to be direct. Lacking the emotional vulnerability, you know, and it's negative. It's some positive aspects to it, right? Because I operate in my logic a whole lot because I've learned how to flip the switch to my emotions, okay? But it says whatever situation you are referring to has been happening in a repetitive, ongoing manner. The whip card often relates to communication, so may involve arguments, banters, negotiation, prayers, mantras, incessant nagging, criticism, or bickering. It's like this is the same conversation that you guys may keep having over and over again, but it never feels like it's any resolution because you guys both collectively responds the same way. So let's just put it that way. You respond the same way each time. Somebody gets defensive, somebody yells, somebody shuts down. You know, it just keeps going back and forth the same exact way. And Spirit is saying, it's time to break that cycle. Okay? It's just time. It's so ritualistic, y'all. It's time to break the cycle. Wow. Look, I already know, okay? My spirit team will read my ass on video, too, okay? So, let's see. That's why I said we in this to win this, y'all. We doing this together. Like, we work in real time. We in spiritual training. This is boot camp. And at the same goddamn time, Spirit is dishing out our collective of people that we supposed to help, okay? So, but we gonna overcome. We got our spiritual helpers and we got each other as earthly helpers. Show me what I need to see. A A new romantic cycle begins. What I tell you, this person is a King of Cups, man. They're willing to balance this out and try to make things work. This person ain't gonna fold on you. If the person folds on you and get the fuck up out of there, they ain't your person, boo. King of Swords. Upright. Okay, this person is coming across very structured, clear in their thinking. Yeah, they're gonna handle this conflict, this argument. They're gonna handle it. They're gonna be the one that's balanced in this. Okay? You the feminine, my collector. You may be the one over there like trying to run. Nah. But they're gonna do the right thing. They're not coming across as, you know, low vibrational, toxic, argumentative. They're gonna be able to handle this situation here where you guys can walk away on or move beyond this, okay, without being hindered by any pain or anything. Air sign energy coming through all day. Let me tell you, let me find out. That's what I'm saying. The transformations is happening. You can see it coming in. King of Pentacles upright. And what they're going to come in offering you is something more serious than what they were doing. Look at that. Two of Cups. They're going to work with you, man. What y'all got is strong. This is a partnership that you are building. Your connection is strong. And they're going to work with you. They see that. They want to be able to partner with you in some kind of way to create this. Okay? You guys, this is your companion. It's going to be better communication. It's going to be balanced. And they're going to actually, you know, treat you as if this is a companionship. Okay? You guys got a strong connection. So what's coming in for you is coming in soon. All right? So now you know, face your mirror, right? Heal what you need to heal and continue to move forward. Anything else, my spirit team? This gonna be the last card I pull because my head about to be like, boop. Show me what I need to see. Prosperity. That's what's coming to you. Your needs are going to be provided. Just follow your intuition and manifest your dreams into reality. I'm telling you, this is your money, your love life, everything. It just requires your balance. And now that you're working on this part of your heart chakra, this is what's going to open you up even more. This having that block, that old sense of abandonment that's been lingering has probably been what's been messing with your cash flow for some of y'all. You not having enough. And now that you know what's happening, spirit is telling me, look, guess what? Even that area of your life is going to open up. You got to be open in your heart chakra to be able to receive. Y'all heard me. I'm telling you, I'm learning it too. Okay, and I'm actually excited, God damn it, because this is like, oh, okay. I got it. I want to be better, right? Because I want to be better for y'all. I got a job to do and I'm open. So I'm open to God's instruction and listening to my angelic guides. They have not stirred me wrong yet. And that's why I'm just so grateful. I'm grateful for the journey. I'm grateful for you guys as well. So thank you so much for tuning in. Thank you for hitting the like button. Thank you for hitting the thanks button if you're feeling generous. And I thank you for everyone who's already hit that thanks button. You guys have made sure I made it through this summer break without feeling like I was going to lose my mind, y'all. But I'm back to work, so thank God. And I appreciate you guys' support. Peace.